Well, we're ready to start another process here. The processes that I've demonstrated thus far, as far as depriming, cleaning the primer pockets, cleaning the shells, just to, can pretty much be done at your leisure. You know, you can start and stop. And I wanted to give you a quick look at some of these. These are all deprimed cases. Okay. These are all cases that have been deprimed and cleaned, ready to get resized. So, you know, as I said before, if you have a lot of shell or a lot of cases from a couple days of shooting, then you can just sit down and basically do those processes at your leisure. Start and stop. Now we're going to get into lubing and resizing here. Get you in the tripod here. Now, there are some aspects to lubing that, bring about great debate. There's different kinds of lubes on the market. The lube we're going to be using here is the Lee lube that came with the kit, resizing lube. And we're doing this by the book as far as what it says in the Hornady manual and as well as the Lee instructions for the resizing die. So, but as I said, it's a subject of a certain amount of debate. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a little out here on the, some consider this messy, but this particular lube is water soluble and is, quote, powder friendly. It won't contaminate your powder or your primers. Some lubes will. Another option to use is the one shot. This is a spray lube, also powder friendly, made by Hornady. Recently picked this up. I haven't actually used it yet, so I thought I'd stick with the Lee lube for this demonstration, since I'm for the most part doing it by the book and with the stuff that came with the kit. Now, when you're lubing the shells, I'm going to use this as my pointer. You want to start from the rim to the edge of the shoulder. You don't want to lube the shoulder or the neck, the outside of the neck, because it'll build up in your resizing die. And then you get little dents, and yes, I have, when I first started out, I actually had that problem. Freaked out. I was like, oh, what's wrong with my dies? Now, when you get into resizing, it is a process that you do not, in my opinion, you do not want to start and stop. You take the amount of cases you want to resize, you lube them up, you resize them, because you will need to clean that resizing die after use. Not necessarily every use, it depends on the interval of which you're using it. Because it will build up in there, and it's just recommended that you do clean out your sizing die. So, anyway, let's get started here on lubing these. And it, Lee says, and Hornady says, to just barely lube the inside of your neck. Okay, so I usually just roll a little out on here, not a lot. And you just run it around the inside. You don't want a big glob. Wipe off the excess. I don't know if you can see it in there. Okay. And then we just put it on. And even Lee recommends doing it with your finger, because the simple fact, you can feel if there's any burrs or, you know, imperfections on your shell. You know. Like I said, this stuff's pretty easy to work with. You know, it's not real greasy or anything like that. So, a little up here we need to wipe off. There we go. So, turn that one off to the side. Now, usually, I'll lube the outsides or lube the necks first and then the rest of it. So, but this is very important. Now, there are some There are some dyes manufactured out there to where you don't have to do this. Call it neck sizing dyes. You don't have to lube. Some very expensive ones. And I also just wanted to throw out that... I'll have to clean that one off. I haven't gave any information as far as setting the dyes, because each set of dyes is different. Each company is a little different on their dyes. So what works for Lee dyes won't work for RCBS dyes. I know it's a little confusing, but you know, it's just one of those things. So, and it dries pretty quick. You know, some people think this is like really messy, and I don't know. Maybe I just like, you know, playing with stuff like this. I don't find it that difficult. Okay. Got us a little rag over here. Wipe off our fingers once in a while. You know, and as some people have said, you know, lube, lube, lube. Lube is your friend. In resizing, that's a definite. Alright, we'll just kind of wring that out a little bit. Just once around the inside. Oop, a little excess there. Now, doesn't have to be so you can see it. Get some excess on there. And this helps your sizing die, the inside part of the sizing die gives it a little lube in there, you know, so it doesn't go so hard. So anyway, that's the lubing part. We're gonna get set up and we're gonna resize these. I'm gonna finish out the rest of those.